Hello and a very warm welcome back to the garden. It's currently peak summer and it's absolutely boiling hot, but the garden continues and I have to come out here and make sure that everything is getting done. And in this video, it's all about harvesting, not just to enjoy all of the summer crops here during peak summer, but also having a rapid succession. So as soon as I harvest some things, I'm going to be putting a lot of crops almost instantly in the same place, which means I'm going to get loads more food through autumn and winter. And I kind of want to show you the different processes that I use for that. As you can see, there's a lot of crops in different stages. These cabbages are just starting to develop. These peas, Llanover peas, are in their prime, but they're still, and the salad bed and the spinach has gone over. There's a lot of things happening in a very short space of time. And this bed here was where we had all of the garlic. It's probably about 150 garlic bulbs, of which we had a fantastic harvest. And the very same day, as soon as the garlic went out, we put in these dwarf beans, because that means, especially at this time of year, every day we can get a new seedling in, the more likely it's going to be to give us a good harvest towards the end of summer and then into autumn. And this is a rapid succession I'm talking about, where one of the principles of having healthy soil is to have plants in as long as possible for as much as possible. So by simply in a matter of a couple of hours, taking a crop out but putting new plants in, we're helping to maintain that soil health, which in turn is going to help keep our plants nice and healthy. Another example was in this bed was the new potatoes, and then straight away transplant the kale. This kale variety here at the base is actually a new one. It's called Hungry Gap Kale, and the clue I think is in the name, in terms of when to harvest and how hardy it's going to be. So I'm really curious to see how that performs. Now here you can see these are broad bean plants, or fava bean, and the quality are diminishing because it's coming to the end of their lifespan effectively. All of the remaining pods have bulked up really nicely, so we've got a ton of broad beans to harvest. And one of the jobs today actually is to go through and harvest all of these broad beans, and we're going to take out these plants and then transplant something in its place straight away. So these onions are bending down, and it's a sign to show that they're getting ready to harvest. Now I could just leave them here for another couple of weeks so they could start to dry up, but what I'm actually going to do is I'm just going to pull them out today, harvest these, and I'll let these dry out in the sun, or if it starts turning a bit rainy, somewhere in the barn. And I'm going to transplant here actually a load of leeks. I know they're in the same family, but because these alliums, and they're showing really strong signs of growth, I think I can risk it with planting leeks here. And where the broad beans are, I'm going to end up planting some kind of brassica in their place. Here's the harvest from this bed of really nice, shiny looking onions that are going to be so nice to enjoy over autumn, winter, and hopefully into spring. This bed is now all clear, as you can see. I'm just going to give it a very light rake and then a very light top dressing of maybe just 1 to 2 centimeters of compost. Just add a little bit extra, and then I'm going to go through and then I'll start the process of transplanting leeks. This is where the broad beans were, and we've also harvested another area of broad beans, which is around half the size. And you can see the sheer quantity of harvest here. It's absolutely amazing. Now, behind me, you'll see that all the leeks have also been planted out. So that's where all the onions are, and 65 leeks have now replaced them. So that's a lot of food. The leeks, will start harvesting them in around November onwards. And here I'm actually transplanting some claret, which is a really productive purple sprouting broccoli variety. I'm going to put around 9 plants here, and you can see that I'm doing them bare root because I like to start them off in a seed bed just to save shelving space in the polytunnel for other seedlings. And what you'll find if you do them bare root is they'll wilt, they'll look sad for a day or two, and then they'll perk back up, just like all these brassicas behind me have done. So you can see in quite quick succession, we had one staple crop here, which are the broad beans, another staple being the onions, and now I'm replacing them with crops that are going to provide stuff, not just for winter, but also like this purple sprouting broccoli for the hungry gap next year. And it's all in the same space. And that can, it's just a demonstration of how productive and how efficient you can be with timing to end up with an awful lot of food from one small area. Another tip when it comes to rapid succession planting is that these kale are gonna start growing quite tall, and there's going to be space underneath, and there's still time to have some cash crops that we can enjoy in early autumn, for example. So I've got some dill and coriander here, and also a load of radish, because in theory the weather's going to start to cool down in August. So things like radish and coriander are going to be great to grow as an understory, almost as like a bit of a cover crop, not too close to the plants but around them. And then you can also make sure that you plant other things for perhaps the edges. For example, I've got fennel seedlings, which I can put at the end of this bed here, just to make the most of as much space as possible that is available before later on in the season, say mid to late autumn, when these plants start becoming quite big. So really it's kind of that mindset of, if I see some space and that space is going to be there for a few weeks, I'm going to take my chances and start planting just some extra crops, just so I can really get as much as possible from this space. Here's a patch of shallots that are just drying off at the moment. And this is an example of another thing that happens around this time of year, where you get smaller spaces start to open up. So you may not have kind of space for like a load of kale plants here, for example, but this is where I start looking at things like root vegetables. And I've got a load of beetroot in modules currently growing, and they're about a week off from being transplanted. So all I'm doing at the moment is I'm actually just, because these are drying off really nicely, I'm just going to harvest and pull up all of these shallots. Give this bed a really good soaking, because it's been so dry, it's good to give that moisture. And then in a week's time, it's just going to be nicely prepped and ready for me to turn up to the garden, put in the beetroot seedlings, and get a harvest of beetroot in autumn. If you've already transplanted your brassicas or your leeks and you're looking for something different to try, then I invite you to trial something alongside what I'm doing, and that is testing how daikon radish grows. And here's one at the moment. Effectively, it's a winter vegetable, and it's really versatile in the kitchen, and now is the time to get it sown. You can sow them direct, just like I've done here. This is more of a test thing, and they germinated so easily. So I'm going to go, and I'm actually probably going to dedicate about half of a raised bed to sow daikon radish, to see if I can utilize it as a winter staple. And I think it's something that you should very much consider. If you've got some gaps coming up, then try grow this vegetable. At the moment, it's very much the harvest stage, the abundant stage of gardening. And one thing you might be looking for is some new recipes to try. Maybe you're looking for new ways of cooking or eating the produce that you grow. Well, I've got some good news. I've been working with a really talented chef, a guy called Sam Cooper, and we've created this project called Farmer and Chef. And the idea of that is to showcase homegrown produce in a quick and easy way of cooking it. So all of the recipes, they may look refined, but they're designed to be super simple that we can all try out and actually enjoy, almost kind of restaurant standard food, but things that we can make in the kitchen with the produce that we grow. It's a real celebration and a real emphasis on the produce that comes out of the garden. So I invite you to check out at Instagram and also the blog, where you can find all of the recipes. And I promise you, there's going to be something there that you're going to absolutely love. Now, I absolutely love this time of year. Yes, perhaps some of the crops are looking a little tired, or we've harvested and some gaps are emerging, but it's an opportunity still to fill up those gaps with young plants that are going to provide harvest well into winter and throughout the hungry gap. And I just wanted to show you the method of gardening that I use, which is a very rapid out with the old and in with the new. And especially at this time of year, if we can just maybe harvest onions a day or two earlier than normal, it might actually make all of the difference at the tail end of the season to give enough growing time and warmth for these second crops to really come into their own and provide us a lot of food. So thank you very much for watching. Hope you found it useful, and it's amazing just in a matter of 2 weeks how much the garden changes. And I look forward to seeing you guys again soon. Goodbye.